That is a spider the size of your hand. That's called a huntsman. It's not venomous, but that doesn't mean it won't bite you.
With teeth?
With fangs that are wide, and they make big holes, and gee whiz, it hurts. I used to pick fruit during summer vacation, pick apricots. I'm climbing 15-foot ladders with a big tub full of apricots. And to pick an apricot, you grab it, you turn it, and you put it in the bin. And you carry that down the ladder, and then you put that on the tractor, and you go back up the ladder, and you do it again. I turn an apricot around, and there's one of those things sitting on it. And you know what it does? It raises its two front legs, and it hissed at me. And I went, ah! And stepped backwards in fear. 15 feet in the air. And next thing I'm laying on the ground going, oh! The huntsman spider. What a nightmare. And those things are fast. We had one in the bedroom. I used to share a bedroom with my brother. And I'm laying on the ground because my mattress was on the floor and the huntsman's running across the ceiling. And I'm freaking out. So now I've got two hockey sticks. And I'm whacking at the wall and whacking, and this thing's running around. I'm smashing up plates and everything's going great. And this thing just ran up the wall and laughed at me. Oh, I hate
that. Oh my God.
That's Bruce. That's Bruce from Nemo. Great white shark. Standard Australian response if you get bitten by a shark used to be, let's go and hunt the shark. These days we laugh at you, go, ha! That's what you get for swimming in its ocean. Right? It doesn't bite you in a swimming pool, so go swimming in the swimming pool. If you get bitten by a shark, we tend to laugh at you and go, that's your own fault. Happens a lot to surfers. Last year, Mick Fanning's out on a board at an event and he starts paddling in. And there's a shark behind him. And And he's just freaking out because this thing was going to have a chomp at him. So you can't go in the water. You can't stay on the land.
You go into space.
You go into space.
Space Australia. Space Australia.
I say the place is trying to kill us.
I feel like if there is a space,
then we should call it
Safe Sunshine.
Hi, Ezra.
World's largest monolith. A freestanding rock. And it's huge under the ground. But you go through the middle of the desert and there's nothing. And it's flat because it's the desert. Then you run across that. Used to be called Ayers Rock. Right, and then in the 80s we did the whole thing about recognizing Aboriginal people. So now we call it Uluru, because that's their name for it. And people climb it. And every year, probably three or four people die climbing it, having a heart attack. Because 30 years ago, some wag put a piece of chain up the side to help you climb up the bloody rock. So people who should know better try and climb it, use the chain. And then it's the middle of the desert, so it's incredibly hot, and they didn't take any water, and then they have a heart attack and die. So even climbing the landscape will kill you. That's a picture from space. And that's a living organism that it's showing. The Great Barrier Reef. It's a living organism. You know the biggest threat to that? White man. Because guess what he's doing on the coast? He's growing stuff. Using pesticides and fertilizers, which runs off into the ocean, which kills the coral. You can see it from space, but you can kill it with Roundup. Not very smart, Australians. We'd do anything to destroy it. Pretty.
Is it also
And deadly. So Sydney Opera House on the left-hand side. The Manly Ferry. You'll be familiar with that cityscape from a movie called The Matrix. Made in Sydney. Sydney Harbour Bridge. For $150 you can climb up it and stand on top of it. Some tour group now has a bridge climb. They go twice a day. It takes 3 hours. Climb up the top of it, look around Sydney Harbour, and go, yeah, that's pretty. But it's not the best city in Australia. That one is. That's Adelaide. Remember Adelaide on the map? That's where I come from. It's called the City of Churches. Because it's got a lot of churches. What it's also got is the festival centre on the right hand side, and so it's a square mile, the centre city. It's a square mile laid out in a grid. East Terrace, West Terrace, South Terrace, North Terrace. Everything runs north, south, or east, west. And it's surrounded by a mile of parkland. On every side, there's parkland. And Adelaide's slightly on a hill. And the idea was that when the Russians invaded, we could use cannon to blow up the Russians before they got to the city centre. Australia was built around the premise that the Russians were going to invade. In Port Phillip Bay, where Melbourne is, there's Queenscliff Cliff. There's a fort with guns pointing out to sea. It's been there for 150 years because the Russians were coming. Australians live in fear of invasion.
Well, why the Russians? You think they'd invade now?
It'd be funny to watch. It would be fun. Australia has a defence plan. Most of our invasions come from the north, because we're in the south. So the Japanese, in December 1942, right, they took a shot at Pearl Harbor, and then they came and bombed Darwin more than 100 times.
What?
Yeah. And they pushed down through Singapore, and down through Solomon Islands, and down through New Guinea, and they had the top end of Australia surrounded. The defence plan was, everybody who's north of the Brisbane line, move south. The top half of the continent, just leave them have it. It'll kill them for us. They can't survive, there's no water, just let them have it. And that's still largely the defence plan. If someone wants to invade Australia, we're just going to move south and say, you want to live up there, good luck. Hope you got air conditioning and bloody good mosquito repellent. Because it's dangerous.